Many industrial sewing machines share features. Take the Stinger 103 and the 188. The first thing you notice is its size, clearly larger than the domestic sewing machines, but apparently smaller than, let's say, the industrial 31K. The 188 is a semi-industrial sewing machine, made to rip your fingers from your hands. It was made to sew really, really fast. The basics were designed in 1911-1912. These machines made it able to sew really fast through fabrics. It was equipped with a super large 18-inch flywheel. Compare this with a normal 13-inch domestic treadle-based flywheel with a 16-inch flywheel. And now, for comparison, take the 18-inch flywheel like the one on the 103. It was, and still is, a true tailor's machine. It was also the first machine to have a lever for a backstitch or reverse sewing. Mechanically, it looks like the system that was used on a domestic 15, and you could be right, because the team that designed the Model 15 also designed this beauty. But unlike the 15 series, this machine does not have an oscillating hook, it has a rotating hook. It's like the industrial 96 and 2001, which is the industrial version of the domestic 201 as seen here. You've noticed these machines have the raised assembly placed horizontally, and in this case, the case was placed vertically. The machine I'm talking about is a 103, but you're looking at a 188K1. You'll know the 99 or the 185K. It looks like I'm on a sidetrack, but bear with me. The domestic 185 is a 99 in another shell. They have the exact same components, but the 185 looks more fresh and modern. The same goes with the 103. It was presented with a new wardrobe. Yep, the 1960s 188 was basically the same as the 103. If you have acquired one, you would like to know how to thread the machine. Let's go and do just that. An industrial machine can handle thicker thread and keeps it under tight tension. Pull the thread through the hole on the left spool pin. Then go to this guide. Top hole, right to left, and then the yarn over the guide and back again, right to left again. Got it! Place the thread underneath this hook. We call it the thread guard. And the tension assembly again, right to left, a little bit up behind the spring, then left underneath this hook, then up through the thread guard, up to the lever, right to left again, then 1, 2, 3 hooks, and change the needle from the left to the right at last. Let's talk about needles. Confusion is imminent when researching on the right type of needle. A needle type is different from needle size. A needle size is similar as when you're drilling a hole. I'm not the right person to tell you what type of needle you should be using, since my 188K is a Frankenstein with a domestic needle bar. Sorry. As far as my knowledge goes, the correct needle size is 16x231 or 16x230. It's also being sold as type DBX-F2, 1738, 287WH and others. A semi-industrial machine has some advantages over the industrial machines. This semi-industrial machine has a screw hole connection on the rear, similar to domestic machines. It also allows you to use a hand crank or a ball motor. It keeps the package smaller.